Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 3 for the first MSK lab. And we're going to be focusing on two separate views of the cranium. We're going to be looking at an inferior view first and then a posterior view. So starting with the inferior cranium, we know we're looking at an inferior view because we can see the bottoms of these maxillary teeth. And for me, I always know I'm looking at an inferior view because I have a very clear foramen magnum right here. So a very large hole associated with the inferior view. You can't really see this unless you're looking into the skull, other than in this inferior view. So let's start with the temporal bone. And you can see that zygomatic arch that we talked about when we were looking at the lateral view. So you can see it in the superior view as well. And then just posterior to that, you're going to have this fairly large depression or fossa that is going to be the mandibular fossa. And this is going to be the T portion of the TMJ joint. So the temporal bone portion. And it's very nice and smooth in this region because you're going to have articular cartilage that would sit there during life because this is a synovial joint, and we know all those synovial joints are going to have an articular cartilage covering. Moving back to the occipital bone, again, here is that large foramen magnum. The foramen magnum is the second largest foramen in the body. The largest will be the obturator foramen that we will see when we get to the pelvic girdle region. And it is here that we get the transition from the medulla oblongata, and at the foramen magnum, it transitions into the spinal cord. And also you will have cranial nerve 11, or the accessory nerve, ascending through the foramen magnum before it will eventually exit again through the jugular foramen. And then you'll also have the vertebral arteries. If you recall in our discussion of the vertebrae in the lecture videos, the vertebral arteries are going to ascend through the transverse foramina of the cervical vertebrae, and then it'll eventually make its way into the skull region through the foramen magnum. Okay, moving to the hard palate region. You know we're in the hard palate because it's going to be very closely associated to the maxillary teeth. The maxillary bones, which you can see one here and one here, are going to make up the majority portion of the hard palate and definitely the anterior two-thirds, where you can see a bit of where the separation is between the maxillary bones and the two palatine bones, the horizontal processes of the palatine bones. So it is these palatine bones that are going to make up more of the posterior portion of the hard palate. But it's really the maxillary bones that are making up the largest amount of the hard palate. And then the soft palate would just kind of hang off this region right here in terms of the muscular region of the soft palate that's covered with mucosa. Looking at a posterior view, really the majority bones that you can see here are your paired parietal bones, but you can't see much in terms of structures there. You can see a bit of the temporal lines extending this way. But the majority of what we see in a posterior view is this occipital bone here. And you can see right in this midline region, a large bump that is going to be so large that we call it a protuberance. So this is the external occipital protuberance, which you can palpate on yourself right on the back of your head in the midline region. And this is going to be one of the attachment points for that large superficial back muscle, the trapezius. Okay, so these are the structures we wanted to identify from an inferior and a posterior view of the cranium. We're not done with the cranium yet. There is a lot to go through. So we'll continue to look at different views, and then we'll focus on things like sutures as we move forward. Please make sure to reach out if you have any questions on the specifics of these structures in terms of their anatomical relationships or why we want to be able to identify these structures. Please ask early and often, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.